Hello dear students, welcome to Learning Chemistry is Easy and Fun. Lesson number 9, topic is coordination compounds. The subheading that we are covering today is isomerism in coordination compounds. Isomerism is something you've done in organic chemistry as well. What do we mean by the term isomers? As I've done here, I've split it. Iso is same molecular formula. That means two compounds which have the same molecular formula but they differ in their physical and chemical behavior due to the difference in the arrangement of atoms in them are called as isomers, and the phenomena is known as isomerism. Now if you notice, I have not written the definition on the board. So the question is to define isomers and isomerism so that your notes are ready for, yes, offline reference as well, right? Here I've taken a very simple example of isomerism in coordination compounds. I have written one formula in red and one formula in purple. Cobalt, yes, both same. Br, Br. 5NH3, 5NH3. Sulfate, sulfate, yes. Each and every atom is the same. But if you notice, here Br is the counter ion, whereas sulfate is the ligand. Whereas in this, the situation is reversed. The sulfate becomes the counter ion and Br is the ligand. Now both these molecules behave differently, their properties are different. That's why I've written them in different colors as well. This is a reddish compound, whereas this is purple in color. If you treat the first compound with silver nitrate, you treat it with silver nitrate, you know the test for halogens. Now here bromide is an ion over here, right? It's ionizable. So it gives you a pale yellow precipitate of silver bromide, which is soluble in excess of ammonium hydroxide. Yes, you know the practical part very well. On the other hand, take the second compound. If I treat this with silver nitrate, I will not get the pale yellow precipitate. On the other hand, if I treat this compound with barium chloride, what will I get? Yes, I will get a white precipitate of barium sulfate. Right? So, these two are isomers. But isomerism in coordination compounds is of different types. In order to make the understanding simpler, what we've done is I have divided into the form of a chart. Isomers, two, structural, stereo. Structural means wherein the isomers or the molecules differ only in position with respect to each other, right? Like the example we saw here, this is an example of structural. Stereo, on the other hand, is where they differ with respect to each other. Sorry, not each other, but with respect to position in space. So if I have a square planar complex, they can be on the same side of that complex. They can be on the opposite side of the central line. So that is just one example. Structural divided into linkage, coordination, ionization and solvate. Stereo divided into geometrical and optical. Geometrical isomers are of two types, cis and trans isomers. That is why this is also called as cis-trans isomerism. Optical isomers are two types, the D form and the L form, the dextrorotatory and the levorotatory. This is based on their effect on plane polarized light, right? So let us go on to the details of each type of isomerism with examples. But for ready reference, this chart will come in very handy. So if you would like to note it down, you need a pen and paper in your hand, right? So give me the definition of the two, isomers and isomerism, and get this flowchart or the chart in place so that we can move on to the next heading where we take examples of different types of structural isomers. Structural isomerism. Why don't you teach me this topic? And to help you in doing that, what I've done is I've divided the board into four parts. I have written examples over here. Take time to just read through the four types of structural isomerism that we have talked about. We've not discussed, I've just mentioned them, right? Ionization, hydrate isomerism, coordinate, and linkage. If you have understood the concept of coordination compounds, you will be able to place which coordination, which isomerism is in which block of this four squares. Okay, you can pause the video, note down the examples, maybe make bigger squares to write some more examples on your own, right? And then compare the answers that I'm going to discuss over here. It will become very easy and it will become interesting as well. So why don't you pause it and do it yourself first? A big thank you to those who have actually paused and done the questions, because it gives me the encouragement as well that you are involved in the videos. Okay. So the first one, now this is the example that I've already discussed as well when we're talking about isomerism. Now if you notice over here, the ions which are formed are different. So when you break this, this is one complex ion and sulfate is the other ion which is formed on ionization. Whereas if this breaks down, this is one complex ion and bromide is the counter ion. So the counter ions are different in both the cases. So what does this remind you of? Perfect. This is an example of ionization isomerism. Here, this is, we said that this will give you the test with barium chloride. It will give you a white precipitate. It's a violet colored compound. On the other hand, this will give you test with silver nitrate solution, giving you a pale yellow precipitate, right? Which is soluble in excess of ammonium hydroxide. And this was a red compound, yes. Can you relate to the marker color that I used? See how colors help you to remember things. Come to the second example. COCO, NH35, NH35, NO2 and ONO. What's the difference? It's the same NO2. Counter ion is also the same. Yes, it's the atom through which the donation of the electrons is taking place, the ligand atom, the donor atom over here. When I'm saying NO2 nitro, there nitrogen is the donor atom. ONO, if you remember, we'd introduced the concept of mu while talking about nomenclature of such compounds. So here O, nitrito is the group, so O is the donor atom. So what isomerism is this? The linkage groups are different. What type of groups will show this kind of isomerism? Very good. It's ambidentate ligands which will show this type of isomerism. Two teeth. They can bite through two ends, right? Two different ends, but they are unidentate, right? But they can donate from any of the two donor atoms, not both of them simultaneously. Please remember, this is not a chelate effect. Here they can either donate through nitrogen or oxygen. Other examples are like SCN, NCS, right? Urea, urea can donate through nitrogen or through oxygen. So this is an example of, very good, linkage isomerism. I am so glad to see the smile on your face. We are already halfway through. Let's go on to the next, wherein just see the structures. I've taken two examples over here. Let's go on to concentrate on the first one. CuNH3O4, PtCl4. That means what I notice over here is that the cation as well as the anion part is complex over here. Correct? The only thing that has happened is the ions, the metal atoms have switched places in the cationic and the anionic ions. Correct? So they are also very good. This is an example of coordinate isomerism, right? So the way they are coordinating with what lichens they are coordinating is differing. So although the ligands have remained the same, the metal atoms have switched the cationic and the anionic part. Interestingly, if you see over here, in both the cationic and the anionic part, the metal atom remains the same. So we have this, these are not two compounds, this is one compound, so cationic part and the anionic part. Now compare it to the cationic part over here and the anionic part over here. Yes, the ligands have spread out, but the number still remains the same. Total NCS 4 plus 2 is 6. Ammonia 4 plus 2 is 6. But they are distributed differently in the cationic and anionic part. And this also constitutes an example of coordination isomerism, right? So we have given, they've done examples of ionization isomerism, linkage isomerism, coordination isomerism. What is left? Hydrate. Yes, and hydrate means, very good, it means water. It's an example, or it's a special type of ionization isomerism where we are dealing in context of water, right? So we've written three isomers of the same compound, CrH2O6 Cl3. Sorry, there should be, no, this is one here. CrCl H2O5 Cl2H2O, correct? The third one, CrCl2. So if you notice, here this water is outside the square brackets. It's acting as a counter ion. It's acting as a hydrate, right? Whereas this, these water molecules are acting like aqua. So this behavior or this difference in their structures is also depicted in the difference in the behavior of their compounds. So a very simple example I've noted over here, violet, pale green, dark green. What is the difference in colors due to? Yes, the difference in the wavelength of light absorbed that we have already covered under color of coordination compounds. The DD transitions that take place for electrons in the D orbital, right? So let us write down the last hydrate isomerism. Wouldn't it be interesting if you could add two more examples in each of these columns to make your learning complete? It will do you good because you will have practiced. It's different when you read, and it's very much long lasting if you write it with your own hand. So why don't you do that? You know, you'll have more clarity as well. There's another task that I'm giving you now, is to write the applications of coordination compounds. We are going to have a test. Lesson 10 would be a test on the applications, only applications of coordination compounds. That's it. So I'm going to kind of give you a quiz. I'm not going to maybe ask you to describe, but a quiz to test your understanding of the applications of coordination compounds. So after doing isomerism, please devote 10 minutes of yours to draw the applications of coordination compounds in a tabular form to make it easy to remember, right? So let's continue ahead with isomerism, and we will now talk about stereoisomerism. Now that we've done lesson 9, structural isomerism, we shall be doing geometrical isomerism in lesson number 10. So stay tuned.